Hi everyone in cloud computing and welcome to episode 41 of the Cloud Computing Training Show with Brad Nelson and internationally recognized and the world's number one cloud industry expert and thought leader David Linthicum. This show is sponsored by Nelson Hilliard, cloud computing recruitment specialist, placing great people in cloud, IoT, fintech and AI. In this week's show, Dave and I are talking about that Dell EMC will now be training 500 Emirati students in artificial intelligence technology in partnership with the Ministry of Artificial Intelligence in the UAE. Make sure you stay until the end to get David's top three training tips on cloud computing and AI. Hi Dave, it's great to have you on another training show this week.
Yeah, it's great to be here too. I'm looking for the answer to these questions.
Yes, me too. Look, you know, it's an interesting one, but I mean, let's open it up with this. Is what is the Ministry of Artificial Intelligence, Dave? Can you enlighten us on this new religious belief that we have out there?
Yeah, I think it's got to be someone's brother-in-law who decided that he wanted to have a position within the UAE and decided to go ahead and make something up. He's going to be the Ministry of Artificial Intelligence, or she's going to be the Ministry of Artificial Intelligence. And so that's awful specific, but it's kind of funny that it's out there. So I kind of ran across that and it kind of set me back the fact that they have a Ministry of Artificial Intelligence. So I guess they have a Ministry of Serverless Computing, Ministry of Component Computing, Ministry of Distributed Computing, Ministry of PCs, Ministry of Internet, basically every technology that comes along. So we'll take that out for a minute, which I felt rather humorous. But it is important, I think, that the larger nations, this is a very rich set of nations out there that are looking at this technology, really kind of keep up with the way the technology is evolving. And so artificial intelligence is a tough thing to learn. It's going to take some time for people to get very good at it. And I think the UAE in moving in that direction is really kind of a step in the right direction. If you look at their technology that they're able to employ to, in essence, run the oil businesses and run the other things that really kind of drive the economies of those nations. Artificial intelligence is going to be really kind of a prime, tool to do exploration, to do operations, to really kind of take the country to the next level. And, one of the things that, I'm kind of taken back by is that they are leveraging technology more strategically, every year in terms of the way they do things within the UAE, and I think this is going to continue going forward. And so with partnerships with EMC and Dell and 500 students that are basically going to be, artificial intelligence experts, they're able to take the country to the next level. So this is really with looking after their own selfish interests and also getting people trained up in this technology to really kind of put the investment back into the country to kind of take the country to the next level. But it still cracks me up. They have a Ministry of Artificial Intelligence.
Yeah, absolutely. It really does. In fact, I think there's the Church of Azure coming soon, actually, as well. So yeah. That'll be an interesting one. Yeah, look, I think you're right. I mean, there's been a huge amount of, large companies that are working with individuals to supply specific training. I mean, we obviously have covered Microsoft Azure working alongside government to, underpin public sector training, etc. So it's a really interesting thing that Dell and UAE have come together, in order to do that. And it's a small proportion of people in comparison to what's happening on a global scale with AWS in, across the world with what they're doing with their educational programs and what Google are doing, Azure are doing. So I think it's a step in the right direction, isn't it? And as you say, artificial intelligence is a tricky one. It is a hard thing to learn, and certainly 500 people that are going to be key to that industry, which is predominantly oil over there, is going to be fundamental. So it will be interesting to see how that spills out into the rest of the world. What do you think?
No, it's absolutely an investment in the right direction. I think this is going to mirror what other countries do in the region and what other countries do nationwide. Going forward, they may not have a Ministry of Artificial Intelligence, but they'll certainly have lots of folks who are going to be trained up in how AI works and as far as impactful technologies and really kind of taking these countries to the next level, that's going to be it. If you're going to invest in one thing, that kind of leads into analytics, that leads into the ability to look at risks and security, and it really has tentacles and lots of different things we can do much better. Within these platforms. And so what they're doing is they're saying this is strategic to us, and I think that's absolutely right. We're going to train enough people to be viable with the technology. I think 500 for the UAE is absolutely the right number to do. And we're going to, in essence, kind of nurse this along, understanding this technology is going to have a long-term impact, going forward. And who knows? Maybe the United States will have a Ministry of Artificial Intelligence. Who knows?
Yeah, it almost feels like a bit, it could be some sort of Masonic movement where you've got the sort of the priesthood of machine learning.
Yeah, who knows? It could be a cult where they're taking direction from a PC. Probably Alexa.
Yes, Alexa will be running the show. It'll be some sort of cult. There's the infinite pool of knowledge, artificially led by the Ministry of AI. That'd be fantastic. It's a very interesting twist, isn't it?
Absolutely. Yeah, and I think that we're going to see a lot of this going forward. If people are going to invest in one kind of training besides cloud-based training, and this is going to be a subset of cloud, it's going to be AI analytics. And I think that's where the money can be made. And so we're going to see a ton more of this coming forward in the next 5 years. The training is just going to be immense. And we're going to have to take people that are, coming out of college and universities without AI training and turn them into AI analysts, which is, kind of strange. We're actually teaching them twice, but unfortunately, that's the way technology works.
Yeah, I mean, laughing aside, and it calling it the Ministry of Artificial Intelligence. I mean, in some respects, it could be a business model that's looking to roll out and work alongside the larger organizations across the world. Maybe they've got some sort of, educational syllabus that they're adhering to that, give a qualification or a certain expectation at the end of it. So, I mean, you'd like to think they've got the outcomes that the industries are going to need, right?
Yeah, I think it's absolutely a smart move on their behalf, and I think other countries, like I said, are going to mirror this. And I'm seeing so much interest in the United States, Australia, in the Asia Pac regions, Europe, and really kind of getting much more smarter in this technology and how it's going to work. And it's been around for years. I mean, I was an AI. We talked about this in the show. I was an artificial intelligence analyst when I got out of high school, when I got out of college, when I was 21 years old for 4 years, and did Lisp, Lisp-based programming, things like that, and understood the basics of it. The reality is we have much more larger capabilities today. We have the ability to kind of leverage the stuff at economy price that makes it viable for most businesses and most governments out there, and has tremendous value in the fact that we actually have things that can learn, can basically build skill up over time. And that is something that I always found profoundly innovative and creative in leveraging this technology in certain ways. And I think that we're finding the use cases today, and we're going to find many use cases going forward. And ultimately, it's a step in the right direction. So you might as well get smart at this. So the UAE's ability to kind of invest in technology, invest in the training with Dell and EMC, step in the right direction. It's going to come back a hundredfold in terms of the investment they're making.
Yeah, 100%. I agree with you. In fact, I haven't said 100% for a while there. I think that's the first 100% in a while that I've said.
That's right.
Exactly. In fact, I think artificial intelligence has been around for hundreds of years. I don't exactly know when politics become a forefront of governing their people, but politics and artificial intelligence seems to go quite hand in hand. What do you think?
No, I agree. I agree. I agree. I see some very minimal intelligence out there as we start looking into politics. So it's kind of funny how that works out.
Maybe I should say not artificial, but superficial intelligence is probably more coined the phrase.
Narcissistic intelligence, let's put it that way.
Absolutely. Dave, thank you so much for being part of the training show this week. And it moves us on nicely to your top three tips for the training and this artificial world that we're all living in right now. So if you'd like to share those tips, that'd be fantastic.
Yeah, number one, understand the differences between artificial intelligence and machine learning. We have a tendency to kind of conflate the two. And the reality is that AI is kind of a broader category, which machine learning kind of belongs to it, as well as deep learning and other aspects of artificial intelligence. And so you understand that it's a broad category that needs to be narrowed down in certain implementations. So machine learning is typically more of a operationally oriented focus of artificial intelligence, and deep learning has the ability to kind of take different dimensions and do slower-based analysis on the various systems. Not necessarily making operational decisions, but can make informational led decisions based on lots and lots of information. in a very deep way. And so we can come up with very profound things and very profound analytics as to what the right answer is. Machine learning is typically going to be operationally focused, such as the traditional, you know, when we need to change the oil on a tractor, you know, for example, would be a machine learning based algorithm, machine learning based system. Find the cheap stuff in the clouds. Don't use the machine learning stuff that's on premise. It's going to cost you lots of money. And so the cloud providers are in essence giving machine learning and artificial intelligence and deep learning kind of systems away for very little money. And so use the information there and use the technology there. That's going to be the cheapest way to go. And then finally, data is everything to AI. And so the more information that you have associated with your artificially intelligent system, whether it's machine learning based or deep learning based, the better outcomes, the better understanding that those things are going to have. So one of the things we have to do is when we create the learning models is have them go through petabytes of information so they can learn the patterns within the information. You know, as a doctor would experience certain treatments and outcomes, and the ability for artificially intelligent based systems to in essence do the same thing using information that we provided in terms of, you know, what kind of treatments occurred and outcomes occurred as an instance of that. It could be anything. But the reality is that the more data you have that's associated with this, the better you're going to be with these systems going forward. So make sure that if you have an AI system that's perfectly well and good, you have to have the information that's aligned with the AI system so it can make the appropriate decisions and learn.
Great top three tips there, David. Thank you so much.
Thank you, man. Always a pleasure.
Thanks, Dave. Thanks for being part of the training show this week. Always a pleasure.
It's always great, man. Thanks for inviting me.
Excellent. And thanks for watching, everyone. We really hope you enjoyed watching this week's training show. Remember, David's on Twitter, so if you want to reach out to David on Twitter or myself, that's great. We'll have the links in the description box below. David's Twitter handle is @DavidLinthicum. Mine is @Nelson_Hilliard. We're also on Instagram, Facebook, YouTube, Twitter, all the other social media platforms you can think of as well. We've got lots of these shows as well, so go back and watch some more because they're awesome. We get some great feedback on the shows, which is fantastic. And remember to like, subscribe, comment and share this video with your friends and your colleagues. And when you do subscribe, remember to click the notification bell in the top right hand corner. And again, thanks for watching, and until next week.